Do you want to make your own social media website just like Facebook? Then this video is for you, because in it, I'm going to show you how to create a social media website using WordPress. I will specifically show you how to create a social media website using BuddyPress completely for free. I will show you how users can join your social media website. I will also show you how users can send and accept friend requests, and also show you how they can send and reply to private messages. I will show you how to create groups and even invite users to join. Also, I will show you how to get a custom domain name and web hosting. I will even show you how to install WordPress. WordPress is the free software that we will use to create our website and also customize it the way we want. And don't worry if you are new to WordPress, because I'm going to hold your hand every step of the way. By the end of this tutorial, you will have a fully customizable social media website to start socializing with. So, if you want to create your own social media website, keep watching. Hello guys, this is Sonic here at Tiku Pages Web, where I do web tutorials just like this one. So, if you are new here, consider subscribing. That said, let's jump into the video. To create our website, we are going to use only free resources. The only thing we need to pay for is a domain name and a web hosting, which is a standard for every website. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to get your own custom domain and web hosting. So to get a custom domain name and web hosting, click on the very first link in the description down below. Or you can go to your browser, enter tikupages.com in the address bar, then /Asura. Enter. This brings us to asurahosting.com. Asura Hosting offers multiple affordable hosting services to suit you perfectly. They have website hosting, reseller hosting, VPS hosting, and radio hosting. So for our purpose, we are going to web hosting. Asura Unlimited Web Hosting. It's a shared hosting that comes with unlimited bandwidth, NVMe Express SSD disk storage, email accounts, and many more, where you can choose between cPanel or Direct Admin when you are signing up, with up to 30% recurring discounts when billed annually for longer periods. Now let's take a look at the various shared hosting plans. Now with Asura Hosting, you can choose from Starter, Unlimited, and Unlimited Plus, where you can switch between Direct Admin or cPanel. So you can either decide to use Direct Admin, where you pay $1 per month for Starter, or cPanel, where you pay $1.29 per month. So depending upon whichever control panel you want to use, either Direct Admin or cPanel. So for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to use Direct Admin, where I will pay less. So these are the various features you get under the Starter. You get 12 GB NVMe Express SSD storage, unlimited bandwidth, unlimited free SSL certificates, 15 email accounts, 15 websites, 15 databases, and many more. However, with the Starter, you don't get to have private name servers, free gold, 10K reseller plan. You don't also get free domain yearly or free dedicated IP. Now, for the unlimited package, everything you get is unlimited, except that you will not get free gold 10K reseller plan, free yearly domain, and also you won't get free dedicated IP. And lastly, with unlimited plans, you get all the features which are unlimited, and you also get free domain yearly as well as free dedicated IP. So I will recommend you to go in for the unlimited plus if you want to get extra features that the Starter and the unlimited does not come with. Now going down, it is very important to take notice that when you are using the Starter, for instance, you were paying $12 for a year, and at a renewal you also pay $12 for a year. You don't need to pay extra for subsequent years as other web hosting platforms do. So going up, I'm going to use the starter package for this tutorial. So I click on order now. So in here, I can register a new domain or transfer my domain from another registrar, or I use my existing domain and update my name service. So in here, I'm going to register a new domain. So I search for the domain I want to use. Take note, the domain name you are going to use should be unique to you. If a particular domain is already registered, you cannot also register it for the second time. So let me search for a domain that I want to use. Deku Pages, and then the domain extension, you can drop down the arrow here and choose the particular domain extension you want to use. Now, if you are creating for a business and you want to go international, I'll recommend you use .com. You can go ahead and use .net, .org, .biz. You can go ahead and use .org if you are creating for an organization, that is, for instance, an NGO. I will always recommend you use .com if you want to go international. So I choose .com, then I click on check. So if this domain is not registered, it will be available for me to use. But if it is registered, I cannot register it for the second time. So you see, DekuPages.com is unavailable. What this means is that the domain name DekuPages has already been registered. Perhaps if I want the same domain name, I can go with a different domain extension, that is either .org or .net and whatever. But I want .com, so I'll search again. So instead of DekuPages, I will say DekuPages web, then I click on check. Awesome, congratulations, DekuPagesWeb.com is available for $99.99. So I click on continue. So these are the various features I'll get for the startup plan for the web hosting, which is $12 per year. So going down, you can choose your billing cycle, either annually, 2 years, or 3 years. However, if you choose more than a year, that is 2 years, you save 16%. And you also save 16% when you go in for 3 years. You can also choose additional services like dedicated IP, either monthly or yearly, Ballista license, WHMCS, starter license. We don't need all this. So what I do is I click on continue. And in here, I have the opportunity to use free DNS management. So I check this. IP address, I need to pay for it. I don't want to pay extra. And then email forwarding is free, so I check it. Then I click on continue. I like free things. And now the web hosting for startup plan is $12 per year, and then the domain registration is $99.99 per year, and everything amounts to $21.99 per year. Now going down, you can choose your currency depending upon where you are coming from. I'll leave it as dollars. If you have a promo code, you enter it in here. And finally, billing details. So if you are an existing customer, you click on existing customer login and then continue. But here is the case, I'm going to create a new account. So in here, I fill all these details: my first name, last name, email address, phone number, which is optional, then my billing address, company name, which is optional, street address, city, state, and then country. Then in here, I enter my password and confirm my password. Now, payment method, you can go by PayPal, you can also pay by direct credit or debit card, you can also pay with Bitcoin. So I want to pay with my debit card, so I select that. Now in here, I enter my card number, the expiry date, and then the CVV number. Afterwards, I click on checkout. So now I'll fill all these details and go ahead and click on checkout and get back to you. Okay, my order is placed. I click on continue to client area. And now I am in my Asura hosting dashboard. And right there is the domain I've registered, DekuPagesWeb.com. Now let's go ahead and check our email for the login details to Asura web hosting. Alright, I'm in my Gmail account, and Asura will send us so many messages. So for the first time, you need to confirm your domain name by going here. Because I'm already on Asura, I won't get that confirmation link. By you coming to Asura for the first time, you need to click on the link just to confirm your account. So I go back, The next thing I'll do is look for Asura Hosting, that is hosting account information. So I click in here. Then this particular email will have the login details to my Asura Hosting platform. Right here, I have my control panel login details, which I need to hide for obvious reasons. So to be able to log into your control panel, you need to open the server URL. So I'll just highlight it and I can right click, copy, open a new tab, paste it in, enter. Then I'll go back and grab my username and password. So I'm just picking the password because the username is simple to remember. Then I click on sign in. And now we are in Asura Hosting cPanel. And these are the various features you get when you host with Asura Hosting or any other hosting platform. So that's it, guys, on how to get a domain name and a web hosting with Asura. The next thing I'm going to do is to go ahead and install WordPress. To install WordPress, I scroll down to extra features and I click on SoftaClose Auto Installer. With SoftaClose Auto Installer, you are just a few clicks away from installing WordPress. So I click on it. I have WordPress right here. I go ahead and click on install and I choose protocol. Make sure it is set to HTTPS since Asura Hosting will give us free SSL. And in here I have a bunch of domains, so I choose the one I've registered. Then in directory, you don't want to put anything there, otherwise whatever you put there, your website will be installed there, and you don't want to do that. Going down, site settings, and the site name, I change the name of my website. Deku Connect, and the site description. Social network for all. In the admin username, I enter my name. Password, I'll hide it. Email, I'll use my Gmail account. That is the one I used to register with Asura. Perfect. I scroll down. In here, you can choose the language you want to install WordPress with. I'm going to leave it as English. I scroll down to the bottom, click on install, and WordPress will install in some few seconds. I'm doing this in real time. Awesome. Congratulations, the software was installed successfully. You can click here to take you to the home page of your website. Perfect. Or you can also click on the administrative URL to take you to the back end of your WordPress website. I don't want to do that. I'll use this particular one to show you how you can log into your WordPress website. So to log into your WordPress website, you click at the end of your URL, then you bring /wp-admin, hit enter, and this will take you to the login page. So I enter my username and my corresponding password. Enter. And now I'm in the back end of my WordPress website. The next thing I'm going to do is to clean up WordPress. So I dismiss this. I click on screen options and I take off all these widgets by unchecking all these checkboxes. Perfect. Next, I go over to appearance. Defaultly, you get these three themes when you install WordPress, and this is the active one. So I go ahead and delete those that are not active by clicking on theme, delete, okay, theme details, delete, okay. I will later on delete this theme, that is after I install the theme I want to use to make this website. Next, I go over to plugins. I don't need these two plugins. They are not even activated anyway. I check all, bulk actions, delete, apply. Okay, and off they go. Next thing I'm going to do is go over to permalinks and click on general. In here, I can change the name of my WordPress website and also the tagline, which we have seen during the installation. So over here, if you realize that your website is not secured, meaning you don't have the HTTPS here, all what you need to do is just add the S here and go ahead and save your changes. But Asura will always make sure you have the S here. That is when you choose HTTPS during your installation. In here is my administrative email address. I can change it if I want. And the membership, you want to check this checkbox so that users of your website will be able to create accounts. Going down, I click on save changes. Next, I go over to permalinks and I want to change my custom settings from day and name to post name so that my post will assume this post sample instead of having year, month and day as part of the URL. Scroll down, click on save changes. The next thing I'm going to do is to edit my profile. So I go over to my name right here, click on edit profile. Going down, so this is my username which I cannot change. So in here I enter my first name and then my last name. So display name publicly as I choose this, and I'm getting this combination as a result of specifying my first name and last name in here. Then I go down, click on update profile. Now that we have finished cleaning up our website, the next thing I'm going to do is to install a theme. A theme is basically the design and layout of your website. So currently, if I go to the name of my website, open link in a new tab. So currently, this is the theme I'm using. That is the green background and the black text, which is very boring. So we are going to install a theme, which will make our website a perfect one. So I go back to the back end of my website, click on appearance. Now we are going to download a theme that we will use for our website. So I go over to a new tab and I enter dikupages.com/BuddyX. Hit enter. I'll leave a link to BuddyX in the description down below. It's an affiliate link. I'll get a commission when you buy BuddyX. But take note, we are only going to use the free version of BuddyX. So I'll go over to Teams. So if you go to Teams, you see BuddyX Pro Team and then BuddyX. First of all, let's take a look at the Pro version of BuddyX. Then click on Buy Now. So with the Pro version, you get a whole lot of features for your website. So these are the basic prices. You can also go to Lifetime. So you can buy this theme at $399 for unlimited websites. So let's scroll up, then we go over to Themes and choose BuddyX theme. That is the free version. Now click on free purchase. So this is the BuddyX theme. The price is zero. So to download it, you need to go ahead and enter your personal details in here. So I'll do this pretty quick and get back to you. Okay, I'll fill out the details, then I'll go ahead and click on free download. Purchase confirmation. Thank you for your purchase. And down here is my BuddyPress theme. So I just go ahead and click on it to download it. Click on OK. It is downloaded. Then I go back to the back end of my website. Click on add new, then click on upload theme. Click on browse. I go over to my downloads folder, then I select my theme. Click on install now. It is installed. I go ahead and click on activate. So the theme is activated. Meanwhile, I have an update. So I just click on update now. It is updated. Now let's take a look at the new look and feel of our website. So I right click on the name of my website, open link in a new tab, exit out of here. So this is the new look and feel of my website. I exit out of here. So after installing the BuddyX theme, you need to install this recommended plugins, that is Classic Widgets, Elementor Page Builder and Cricut Toolkit. So I click on begin installing plugins. I'll select all, go to bulk actions, install, apply. Plugins installed. I return to required plugins installer. I check all, bulk actions, activate, apply. Awesome, plugin successfully activated. The next thing I'm going to do is to install the BuddyPress plugin that will enable us to convert our website into a social media website. So I go over to plugins and I click on add new. So this is BuddyPress. I click on install now. It has over 200,000 active installations. It is installed. I activate. BuddyPress is successfully activated. I exit out of here. I don't need this widget. I go ahead and remove it. Now let's go over to settings. Then we click on BuddyPress. So in here, you need to make sure that all these checkboxes are checked. So I'll just select here to make sure everything is checked. Then I click on save changes. Next, I go over to options and the member settings. I check invitations, scroll down and then post comment. I check that as well, then click on save changes. Next, I go over to pages. Everything here is intact, so we don't need to do anything. Take note, all these pages are created for you the moment you install and activate BuddyPress. You can confirm that by going to pages. We have all these pages. Perfect. Now that all the basic settings are done, let me take you through as to how users can join the social network. So I'll just go ahead and open a new browser. Then I enter my web address. Now before we continue, I would like to take off this administrative bar. That is where we have login and then register. I don't want people who are not logged into the website to have access to this bar. So I'll go to the back end of my website. Then I go over to settings. And I click on BuddyPress, click on options, then toolbar, show the toolbar for logged out users. So I'll uncheck it. I save the changes. Now if I go back to the website and refresh it, the administrative bar is gone. Now for somebody to be able to register, they will need the registration page. So I can go back to pages to get that registration page. So I have registered in here. I'll just right click on view, copy the link, and I come back here and paste it in here. Hit enter. So this is the registration page. It's not looking all that great. I'll show you how you can make this page a perfect one. That is if you want it so that all the fields will be placed vertically. However, you can also give your users the opportunity to add some other details to their accounts anytime they want to register. At the moment, you see username, email address, their names, as well as password. You can decide to add profile details like date of birth, phone number, or even a field about your users. So quickly, let me take you through how we add these fields before we go ahead and register a user. So I go back to the back end of my website. Then I go over to users and I click on profile fields. So at the moment, this is what we have. That is the name. So I go ahead and click on add new field. Then the name, I make it phone. Then what type of field is it going to be? It's going to be a phone number. And in here, you can give it a description if you want. At the sidebar, you can decide to make this field a requirement so that it will be a mandatory field for your users to fill. I don't want to make it required. I can also decide to add this particular field to the sign up form so that each time users want to register, you can go ahead and fill in their phone numbers. In the visibility, you can decide to choose any of this if you want everyone to see the phone number, if you want only you to see the phone number, if you want only members, or that is all members on the website to see the phone number, or if you want only your friends to see the phone number. At the moment, I'll leave it as everyone, and I'll give users the opportunity to override these particular settings. So I'll leave all these settings as they are. Yeah, go ahead and click on save. So the phone field is added. So if I go to the registration page and refresh it, you will not see it because we have not added it to the registration page. So if I go back, then I go ahead and add another field. This time around, I'll add date of birth. Then which type of field is it going to be? It will be a date selector, so that user will be able to select their date of birth. And in here, which date format do I want to use? I think I'll leave it as it is. However, you can choose any of these date formats, and I'm going to make it a required. I'll also add it to the sign up form, and I will leave the rest as they are. Then I go ahead and click on save. So now if I go to the registration page and refresh, you see date of birth field as part of the profile details. Awesome. And finally, I'll go ahead and add about field. So I click on add new field. I'll just go ahead and enter about. Then the type, I choose multi-line text area. And I'll leave the settings as they are. I'm not going to add it to the sign up form. And I will make it a requirement. Then I'll go ahead and click on save. Awesome. Now let's register the user. So I enter the username, email address, the password. I'll hide it. This is the password is weak. I'll confirm the weak password. And under profile details, I enter my name, date of birth. Go ahead and choose a random date of birth. Awesome. Then I click on complete sign up. Check your email to activate your account. So as soon as users register on this website, they will have to confirm their accounts through the email address they have used. So people cannot just come and create any accounts anyhow. So you have successfully created your account. To begin using this site, you will need to activate your account via the email we have just sent to your address. So the email I entered does not really exist. In that case, the user will not be able to activate the account. But I'll just go to the back end of my website and approve the user, or activate the user. So I go ahead to users. So currently I'm the only person in here, and you see one pending. So I click on it. So this is the user who just got registered. I'll click on activate. So these are the details the user has registered with. I click on confirm. So the user is activated. And if you go to all now, you see all the users on the website. Awesome. Now let me go back to the other browser to log in the user. So at the moment, people will not be able to log in because they don't have access to the login URL. So to get the login page, you just have to remove the register from here, then enter login. Enter. So I enter my username and then password. Enter. Alright, so as soon as they log in, take them to the home page of the website. So now when users log in, they wouldn't be able to perform any activity like create activities, post group, and even add friends to their friend list. So the next thing I'm going to do is to give them access to the menu where they can actually go ahead and start using the website. So I go back to the back end of my website. I go over to appearance, click on menus, and the menu name I enter main menu. I click on create menu. Under pages, I go ahead to view all, and I select all the menu items I want as part of my menu. I click on add to menu. Then in here, I can rearrange them the way I want. If I want groups to be next to home, I can do that, and members to also be next to group. But I think activity should come under home, followed by groups. Okay, members should come before groups. Then I go ahead and click on primary. If you don't click on this, the menu will not appear at the header. I click on save menu. So if I go back to the user and refresh this page, I'll now see the menu. So with this, they can go ahead and start posting activities and also have access to the groups page. So here, if the user has some message, this is where it will show, as well as a notification. You can also go ahead and click on their name here, change their profile. Let's go ahead and do that. So I click on the name. So in here, they can start adding their activities. Maybe I'll just go ahead and add an activity. I'll say hello guys, I'm new here, so let's connect. So I click on post update and it is posted. Perfect. So up here is personal. That is what we are currently seeing. And then we have mentions, favorites, friends, and then groups. Mentions has to do with some tags. When people tag you in their post, that is where, this is where you see them under mentions. Now I go ahead and edit the profile by clicking on profile. So at the moment, this is what I have. That is the full name and then date of birth. So next I go ahead and click on edit. So in here, if I want to change the name, I can change it. In the phone number, I enter my phone number. And in here, you see that this film may be seen by everyone. I can change the privacy by clicking on change. So only my friends should be able to see it. I close it up. And the date of birth, I can also change it. And in here, I enter about myself. So I can just go ahead and enter some dummy content. Then I save the changes. I can change my profile picture. Select your profile picture. I'll search for the folder where I have my images. I'll use Van Damme, open. Then I can crop my image. Perfect. Then click on crop image. So it is saved. Next, I go ahead and choose cover image that will display here. Select your profile. I'll just use this image as my cover image. It is uploaded. So the rest of the menus. So the rest of the menu here is notifications, messages, friends, groups, invitation, and then settings. So we shall look at some of them later in the tutorial. Now I want to get people to connect with on the website. So I go to members. So this is myself and this is some other user. Take note, this is my own account. So I can just go ahead and click on add friends. So if I go to the front end of my website, I'll open link in a new tab. I'll see an alert indicating that somebody has sent me a friend request. Right here, you see that. You will have a friendship request from Dana Abu. So I can just go ahead and click on it. So this is the notification. I click on it and I decide if I want to accept the friend request or reject it. I will accept. And if I go to my friends now, I'll see that I have this as my friend. I can go ahead and go to their profile by clicking on them. So in here, I can cancel the friendship. I can send him a public message. I can also go ahead and send him a private message. So let's look at how we can send message. So I'll choose private message. So I'm sending to this user the subject. Welcome on board. Maybe the message I say, hi there. Then I click on send. So the message is being sent. So the other user will also see a notification right here that indicates that he has a new message. So if you cannot see it, just go ahead and refresh the page or the website and you see some notifications. So I just go ahead and click on the notifications. So I have two notifications. Take note, the friend request acceptance will come with a notification and the new message too will come with a notification. So I can just go ahead and click on it, the message. So this is the message, hi there. And the subject is welcome on board. I can also go ahead and reply to this message saying thanks for accepting me, something like that. Then I click on send reply. So basically this is how users can send messages. So the next thing I'm going to do is to create groups. So I go ahead and click on groups. So at the moment there are no groups, so I go to create a group. And the group name, I enter movie stars. That's the name of my group. In the group description, I'll go ahead and enter some dummy content. Then I click on create group and continue. So in here, under privacy options, I have the opportunity to select what kind of group I want to make it. Do I want to make it a public group, a private group, or a hidden group? I will leave it as public. Then I scroll down, group invitations, which members of this group are allowed to invite others. So you can go ahead and choose whatever options you want. I'll leave it as all group members. I go to next step. So in here, I select my group profile picture. So I click on select your file. So I'll just choose an image from here, then click on open. I'll crop it. Take note, the pictures I'm using are Creative Commons pictures. So I click on crop. You don't want to use images that don't have commercial use rights. So I go ahead and click on next. Now I can upload a cover image. So I click on select your file. I'll choose this, open. It is uploaded. I click on next. So in here I can invite my friends to join my group. So I just click on the plus icon right here. That is invitation or invite, to invite this user or this friend. As soon as I invite the person, I'll see send invites right here. I can go in there. If I want, I can add up a message saying please join my group. Okay, then I send the message. I go ahead and click on finish. Awesome. So the other user will see a notification telling him to join his group. Perfect. So let me go ahead and add some activity for the group. So I click on what's new. I'll say this is a new equal 4 movie stars. Perfect. Then I post the update. Now at the moment, users of this website will not be able to add any media to the website. So if I try to add something, you didn't see a button or an icon that indicates that you can actually add an image, a video, or an audio file. So the next thing I'm going to do is to give users the opportunity to be able to add media to their activities. But before I do that, let me go back to the other side and accept the group request or the group invitation. So I go to notifications. In here, you have an invitation to the group movie stars. So I click on it, then I accept. Awesome. So I'm now a member of the group. If I go to groups, I'll see all groups that I'm a member of. I can go to the group. I can also add my activity to the group. So I'll say thanks for the adder. Post update. Awesome. Now let me go ahead and give my users the opportunity to be able to add media to their activities. So I go back to the back end of my website. Then I go over to plugins, add new. Under search plugins, I enter RT Media. I have RT Media here for WordPress, BuddyPress, and BBPress. I install it. So this plugin will give users the opportunity to add media to their activities. It is installed, I activate. So after it is activated, right here you see RT Media, click on it. So under display, allow user to comment on uploaded media. I put it on. Media likes, enable like for media, it should be on. Enable gather media search, I want to put it on so that people will be able to search for images on my website. And the rest I leave them as they are. You can decide to put everything on if you want. Next I go over to BuddyPress. All this should be on. Enable media notification. So when people upload media, other users or friends should be able to see the notification. Create activity for media likes. No, I don't want to create activity. If you toggle this on, anytime somebody likes your image or media, it will come as an activity. I don't want that. And I don't also want to put on create activity for media comments. So I leave the rest as they are. Next, I go over to types. What type of media can users upload onto the website? So they can upload a photo, a video, and a music. Or maybe I don't want them to add videos to my website. So I just go ahead and put it off. Next, I go over to media sizes. So anytime an image is uploaded, these are the various sizes to crop the image to. I don't like the cropping, so I just go ahead and toggle everything off. However, you can decide to choose whatever sizes you want. And I think the rest, everything is cool. So I go ahead and click on save settings. Now let's try this out. So I go back to the other user. I'll go to activity. Then if I click on WhatsApp new, I'll now see this icon, which means I can add an image. So I go ahead and click on it. Here I'll choose this image and I click on open. So it is uploaded. I can say something if I want, or I can just go ahead and post only the image. So I click on post update and the image is posted, but it is too wide. So we'll fix this later by adding some sidebars at left and right. Perfect. So we can just go ahead and add the sidebars. So I go back to the back end of my website as an administrator. I can also go to the home page, or maybe sorry, activity page. Then I click on customize. I scroll down to widgets, then community left sidebar. I click on it, then I add a widget. So what do I want to show at the left side of my activity page? So I want to show recent active members. I click on it and it will display right here. Now I go back. I also want to add who is online. Perfect. Click on done. And finally, I'll add primary navigation. Awesome. So I have my primary navigation here. I go back. I click on activity directory right sidebar. I click on add widgets. So I want to display some right sidebars. First of all, I choose profile completion, which will appear right here. So don't worry if it's not showing, it will come. So you can also decide to hide this particular widget when users are able to complete your profile, but I'll leave it as it is for now. Click on done. I'll add another widget. Now I'll go in for latest activities, and these are the latest activities. Maybe I don't want updates. Maybe I want to display new members, or maybe friendships. So you can pick whatever you want. You can also pick more than one category. So for instance, if I pick friendships, I can also go ahead and pick profile updates. So to do that, you need to hold down control, then click on the other option. So you see that profile updates is selected. If I scroll, you see friendship selected. Awesome. And everything will appear right here. So I'm happy. I click on publish. So if you add a particular widget and you are not seeing it, you have to be patient. Sometimes it takes time. So you see that everything is now perfect. The image will be fitted very well in the middle of your page. Awesome. So I exit out of here. The next thing I'm going to do is to make my activity page as my home page. If I go to the home page now, you see that it's very boring. So I want to make the activity page as the home page, so that the moment users log into the website, they are redirected to the activity page, which I will make as my home page. Perfect. So I go back to the back end of my website, then I scroll down to settings and I click on reading. Under your home page displays, I choose a static page. Under home page, I drop down the arrow and I choose activity. Scroll down, save changes. Now if I go back to the front end of my website and refresh the page, activity will disappear, meaning it is now my home page, and you see the home menu to be active. Awesome. Now let's go ahead and customize our website. So to do that, I go over to customize. Let's go to general site layout. In here, you can decide to use the first one, and this is how it will look like. But I prefer to use the full width and not the box layout. So I go back, site loader. I don't want to enable this. And then page mapping. Maybe you may want to make your login page as register and registration page register. Go back. Typography. You can change the typography of your website. Site title. You can change the typography, but I don't want to change it since I'll be changing the logo. Maybe the body. I'll change it from Open Sans to Railway. So the body of my website will change to Railway. Awesome. I go back. Site header. I don't want to do anything here. I'll go to site scheme. That is where I can set my colors. First of all, I'll change the theme color. So currently the theme is using this red color. This notification, you see that the color there is red, so I can change it. So in here, I enter F7A700. Perfect. So this is the color I want to use as my theme color. You see that the notification is now changed to this color. Awesome. The link color is black. I'll leave it as it is. Then link hover. So I just copy this color, link hover. So I paste it in here. So now if I hover on links, I'll see this color. This will not affect this because this is menu links. We'll change that as well. Button background color, I'll use the same color. Button background hover, I'll use the same color, maybe a little bit darker. Awesome. Button border, paste in the same color. Button border hover, the same color but a little bit darker. Awesome. I go back, I go to site sidebar. I want to use this layout, so I select it. I don't have blog posts on my website, so I don't need to do anything here. However, you can just go ahead and select whichever style you want. Activity directory, I choose this, it's already active. Members directory, so I choose the two sidebars for all of them. Now I also have sticky sidebar. See that when I'm scrolling, the sidebars are fixed. If I disable it and I scroll, the sidebar will also scroll, but I need it fixed. I go back. Next is site footer, copyright section. That is what I have down here. I don't want powered by, so I'll take it off. Awesome. Then the hover color, I enter in my gold color. Now I go back, site identity. In here I can add my site logo, so I click on select logo, upload files, select files. Now I go to where I get my logo, have my logos in here, choose this, click on open. It is uploaded. I select it, skip cropping, the logo will appear right here. Perfect. So now that I have my logo, I don't need to display the site title and tagline. So down here below I have site icon, that is the little icon that will appear here. So I'll go over to upload files, select files. I have my site icon here, open. Just uploaded. I click on select and I skip cropping, and I have my site icon right here. Perfect. I publish. Then I go back. Site colors, I don't want to do anything here. Next, I go over to widgets. We've already seen some widgets. So first of all, let me go to members. So I have some left side widgets. So I go to members directory, right sidebar. I'll add some widgets there. So I search for members. I have it right here. Click on it. Okay, I think I already have members here. Okay, this is recently active members, so I can have members here. I'll add another widget, maybe latest activities. Now choose new members. So the display of the members, I don't like it, I can change it. I go back and I scroll down to BuddyPress niveau loop layouts. So members, I change it to two columns, and I think this is good. I'll just go ahead and do the same thing for friends, groups, and then group members as well. So I choose two columns for all of them. So I go back to my widgets. Now I go to groups. So group two, I have one sidebar. Now go over to group directory, right sidebar, add widgets. I'll add groups. Perfect. Maybe I'll add recent activities for groups.
that is group updates. I go back, member single profile. So let me choose a member, maybe this. So I add widgets, maybe I add friends. So the member will see their current friends. So you can choose to show active friends, new friends, or popular friends. Perfect. However, user can also click here to check them out. Awesome. You can add whatever number of widgets you want. Maybe who's online. And I go back. And I have groups, single sidebar. So let me choose a group. I go to groups. So whilst it's loading, let me go ahead and add. So what do I add? Yeah, add groups. So let me open up a group, and I'll also go ahead and add maybe latest activities for group. I'll add group memberships. Awesome. Something like this. I go back. Next, I go over to BuddyPress Niveau. Even though I was here, but I'll still do some custom settings. General BuddyPress settings. If you want to use round style for members, that is for the profile images, you can choose that. I think the square is cool for me. I go back. Group front page. Don't want to do some customization here. Now let me go ahead and change the colors of my menu links. So I go back to typography, then I click on menu hover color. I enter my color. Awesome. And I can also change the font family for the menu to railway. So I think all the customizations are done by my requirements. So I just go ahead and publish. Now before I exit, let me show you how you can rearrange your registration page. So if I go back to and log out this user. So this is the registration page. Earlier on, I mentioned that I'll show you how to change this. That is the layout. So you can do that under customizations. So I go to additional CSS, and in here, I just enter this CSS code. So this will make the whole registration field become a full width. I publish it. Now let's go and refresh this page. So this looks better now as compared to the previous one, but the choice is yours. You can choose not to change this layout. So I can now exit out of here. And one last thing I want to do is to add a user menu so that when users point on their name, they will see a menu just like this one. Maybe if you don't want to display this administrative bar for the users. So I go to the back end of my website, then I go over to appearance, then menus. So I click on create a new menu, and I'll call it user menu. I click on create menu. Take note, you will see the user menus. So you need to drop down the arrow under screen options, then you select BuddyPress member. Toggle it back and you see BuddyPress member right here. So drop down the arrow, then select all, add to menu. So everything is set. You can rearrange them the way you want. Then you check the box beside user menu, click on save menu. So if I go to the front end and refresh this page, I'll be able to see the menu when I hover on my name. So this is awesome. So that's it, guys, on how to create a social media website. I hope this video was helpful. If you found value, kindly hit the like button, subscribe, and also enable the notification bell so that each time I post a new video on this channel, you'll be the first to know. Keep watching, and I'll see you in the next video.